surrounds this tubule, right? That's what you see here. We call them peritubular capillaries. These are the peritubular capillaries. They are surrounding the tubule and so that they can take back, reabsorb, right? Reabsorb all the good things into the bloodstream, right? So they pick up 100% of nutrients, right? And the process, you'll learn in physiology. Initially, it'll be facilitated diffusion, and then there'll be active transport, right? So there is the co-transport and all that you'll learn in physiology. So 100% of the nutrients gets absorbed, necessary amount of salts and ions and everything, and a lot of water gets absorbed. Actually, the loop of Henle is for water reabsorption. So by the time that fluid, filtrate, comes into the collecting duct, it doesn't have any more nutrients left in it. It's all went into the blood, right? And what is in this collecting duct now is just urea, right? And to get rid of urea, we do need to use some water. Some water and extra salts, extra ions, and anything you don't want in the blood is what stays in that tubule, right? So the blood capillaries, they absorb all the good things. Now they join to become the, see that efferent arteriole? Then join, see these are blue ones here. They join the cortical radiate vein, and then arcuate vein, right? And then the interlobar vein, and segmental vein, renal vein, and then to the inferior vena cava. So the blood is going back, and now whatever is left over in that tubule here, collecting that, is what gets drained into the renal papilla here. See these? These are the renal papilla. That's where it gets drained. So, you have this whole thing is what is called nephron. That's the functional unit of kidneys. So one nephron may be filtering less than a drop of blood, but you have billions of those. They all end up filtering 180 liters of blood in a day. Can you believe that? 180 liters of blood in a day. You have about, say, maximum 6 liters. So your whole blood is going through your kidneys at least 30 times a day, right? So kidneys, there are billions of these microscopic nephrons, and each one may be filtering only a tiny drop, but collectively in both the kidneys, all these billions of nephrons filter 180 liters of blood in one day. But all of that, you're not producing 180 liters of urine, right? You only produce maybe 1 to 1.5 liters of urine. So it's only 1% that gets eliminated. 99% gets absorbed back into the bloodstream. That's what is very important about the kidneys. 99% gets absorbed, only 1% is what gets eliminated from the body. And when it comes here, you see, you pour everything into that tubule and your blood capillaries are picking up only what is essential, what is good here, right? So that's what is called selective reabsorption. So the what is taken back into these capillaries is only what is essential. Say you ate a big bag of chips today, right? That has a lot of salt. You don't need all that salt. All the excess salt is left in that tubule. Only what we need is picked up. So, that package says about 20 grams of salt. And if you take collect your urine and check, all the 20 grams of salt will end up in the urine. Right? So that's why, we don't need that much, and the excess, we get rid of it. And you've taken some antibiotics or some drugs and things like that, and they are metabolized in the liver, metabolic products we don't want in the blood, right? That gets poured into that urine and so on. Does that make sense? Right? So the blood goes back, and all that collecting duct, see? There are billions of these collecting ducts that are emptying tiny drops of urine into this renal papilla, and they flow through the minor calyx. See these? These are what we call minor calyx. Minor calyxes join to become the major calyx. All major calyxes empty into the renal pelvis, from renal pelvis into the ureter to the bladder, right? And the bladder is where it gets temporarily stored until it's eliminated. Is that clear? So this one.